The Mixed Mornings and More podcast with Steph and Shawn.
Now available daily.
Good morning, world.
Good morning. Happy Monday. It's June 19th. It's 5:31 and it's you and I, Steph.
I think even though we're late, we deserve a raise just for both of us showing up to work today.
I agree. This is the first time I've seen your face in like 19 days, basically.
Yeah, it has been that long. I've missed you, my friend.
I miss you too. You look great.
You look great as well. Did you get a new beard while I was gone?
A new beard? Yeah, I guess so. It grew back.
It grew back and you trimmed it again?
Yeah. A little over and over. What about you? Your hair's a little longer?
Yeah, I mean, 19 days, it does grow really fast.
We were both in Ontario. We both migrated for a little bit.
No, so crazy across the country, but both of us are back in Fort Mac and ready for some fun today.
That's right.
Loads of fun going on.
Maybe someone could get qualified to win $10,000 a little later on. Two times?
Oh my gosh.
Two times.
Shawn, we're back together and it feels so good.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Just like a calm peace of mind now here in the building.
Yeah, we don't have to do it all by ourselves anymore. But when I was leaving last week, I had to go last minute. Unfortunately, my grandpa passed away. But he was 92 and he had a great long full life. But when I was booking my flights to go, I gotta tell you, there's some secret codes you gotta enter. There's like bereavement things that you have to kind of really Google search for.
Yeah, I didn't even know this was a thing, but you were kind of enlightening me about it.
Yeah, so basically you have to stay on hold with Air Canada for 2 hours and then they'll give you a bereavement code. And WestJet, also you have to call them. It is a myth, basically, on Google. They're like, oh, you call WestJet and they might give you...
They'll tell you a secret number.
Yeah, they didn't even give you a secret number. They just looked up the flights for you to see if they could book them for you. Like, it was, like, very strange.
Interesting.
And the weirdest part about calling WestJet was when I said, like, hey, I see that you might offer bereavement flights. How does it work? And she said, well, who died? I was like,
excuse me?
My grandpa?
Why does it matter?
And she's like, oh, for a grandpa, 20% off.
What?
Yeah.
Different relatives of different percentage?
Exactly. Like, it felt like it was like a sale. Like, it was like, all right, if you lost your grandpa, 20% off. If you lost your brother, maybe 40.
Yeah, I was going to be like, oh, did I say grandpa? I meant like my mother, who's very close to me.
Yeah, it was so strange. And then, of course, they want all the proof that he passed away. Jeez. They want to know who his physician was. They want a copy of the death certificate. They want a copy of the funeral announcement. Like, it was like quite intense. I ended up flying Swoop. It was still a quarter of the price, I think. Like,
unreal. I'm gonna say they take all this information, like, and here's $20 off and you get an extra sandwich on your flight.
Ouch.
Potential life hack alert when it comes to those cheap airlines.
Tell me more.
That we both took them, but the carry-on luggage, you can almost potentially get away with it.
Oh my gosh. Okay, secrets. Yes, tell me your story.
Okay, so I went up to the till and paid for my, like, checked in on my flight instead of checking in online.
Right.
Big mistake number one, because you can check in online and just walk through and use the barcode on your phone as your boarding pass, right?
Yes.
You don't need a physical paper one.
No, you don't.
So when I went in person, they're like, that is not a free item. That's a carry-on. You have to pay $70. So I was like,
$70.
I know. I tried to get away with it, but they got me. So I paid $70 on the way there. And then I was like, the lady said, because you waited last minute, it costs more. But if you pay ahead of time, it'll be cheaper, type of thing.
Yeah, it's only $50 if you pay when you book.
So that's what I did on my way home. I said online, like I logged in like a week before and I went on and I just said, yeah, I have a carry-on with me and I paid the $50. But then I just walked right through. This is on my way home. I walked right through, used my phone, went through security, did everything. I'm like, not one person paid attention to my carry-on.
Yeah, nobody checked to see if you had paid for that thing.
Why did I pay $50 online for this bad boy?
Well, I think that's the life hack, is to definitely pay for it when you book. Or maybe just not pay for it.
Just don't pay for it.
My husband had like a giant backpack and he was trying to use that as his personal bag. And I spent a lot of time worrying about it. Like, my head was spinning. Right. I was like, they're going to make us pay $70 for that. Do not bring that backpack. And he's like, I can't find my smaller one. It's fine. I just won't pack it full. And I was like, it's not fine. I don't want to pay $70 for a backpack that's not even full on the plane. And he just walked it on.
Yes.
And nobody cared. And then on our way back, it was full because, of course, we went shopping when we were home.
Yeah.
And I was like, they're going to make you pay $70. He's like, they're not. And they didn't.
See,
they didn't even care. They didn't even look.
100%. And if worst comes to worst, you just play dumb and you're just like, oh, sorry, I didn't know. I thought it was a free item. And then you pay the $70. But don't pay. Use your boarding pass on your phone. Walk through everything. And at the end of the day, if you have to pay, you have to pay.
Yeah, I feel like we give them a lot of money already to fly. Like, usually I'd be like, no, follow the rules. But this one, I'm just on board with you, Sean.
There
I'm on
we
board
go.
With the
I got to feel a little
later.
Bad over here. I love it.
Last Friday night, I was driving through the night from Hamilton to Sault Ste. Marie.
How long of a drive is that?
Oh, it's about 8 hours.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh.
And the first, like, 2 hours of it is on a big highway, like the 401, and you're kind of, like, weaving in and out of cars. And there was one car that kind of did the journey with us for...
Oh, I always like that a little bit. Well, actually, no. Okay. It depends on what the car is like, what that person is like, if you like it or not.
This person was pretty good. They had their cruise set to probably within a kilometer of our cruise, and so we passed each other multiple times. We were passing friends. But they also, driving through the night, as I said, did not have their headlights on. So there were, of course, when that happens, there are no tail lights unless you brake.
Oh.
And this car, we tried to be good Samaritans and, you know, flash our lights at them. Over and over again.
Yeah.
Anytime we were behind them, we were flashing our lights at them.
Turn on your lights.
Yeah. They'd be like, that's enough. Let's get around them. And this went on for 4 hours.
Oh my goodness.
Of us trying to let them know. And we weren't the only ones. Like, every couple of minutes, be like, oh, somebody flashed their lights at that person again. They still
oblivious
do not,
to it all.
Yeah. And I think they had their daytime running lights on. It was just like those side lights.
Yeah.
And so I guess they thought that
they might.
And perhaps they were like us and rented a car. And so they were like, wow, these headlights are really dim.
Yeah.
I don't know. But they finally realized it. And guess when?
When they turned off.
Yeah, when they were exiting, they all of a sudden were like, oh, they turned their lights on. Oh, see ya. Finally, we thought our friend was going to be our friend for the rest of the way, but with headlights. But
they're probably driving terrified the whole time. Like, oh, everyone's flashing their lights at us. Are they going to, like, run us off the road or something?
Yeah, or maybe they thought there must be cops hiding everywhere.
Yeah,
there's so many
lights. That's right. Like, wow, okay, let's do the speed limit here.
Or maybe they never, ever checked their rearview mirror to see that somebody was flashing their lights. Maybe they were that oblivious and they were so focused on the road because they couldn't see anything in front of them that checking behind them was an absolute no-no.
Those Ontario drivers, I tell you.
Come on.
I just got back from vacation and I spent some time in Ontario. Got to see my parents. They are recently retired. I think my dad's been retired for a bit, and my mom's just recently retired, maybe like 6-7 months or so, Steph.
Right, and they got to actually move away from Regina. Now they're in Ontario.
They've always wanted to live on the water, so they're on Lake Huron, and they're in a retirement community where it's a bunch of like kind of like new build easy homes type of thing. No upstairs, no downstairs, just single floor, and it's all within a community type of thing. Just hundreds of homes type of thing.
Good for retired folk, no stairs. I love it.
100%. And so,
see what you're saying there without saying it, Sean.
And there's constantly new people coming and going, but they've just gotten to know their community so well that they are so retired. Like, when you picture a retired person, it's my parents right now. Like, they drive whenever we're going somewhere, if we were coming or going, they were never in a hurry to get anywhere. It'd be like, we'd be driving like 2 kilometers per hour with just windows down, and they'd just be like peering around to see who of their friends or who is out working on their yard, just so they could like give a wave and be like, hey, Susan. Hey, Cheryl. How you doing? Oh, yeah. Grass looks great today. You know, just like the slow driving and waving to everyone. Like, it's just such a close-knit community. And then on top of that, so that's when we were driving our car. And then they also have a golf cart now.
No.
Because when they got there, they didn't have one. But everyone else had a golf cart. So then they had to invest in one.
A golf cart?
Yeah, it's a golf cart community, I guess. You can just rip around in the golf carts everywhere. And so that was hilarious.
And you just drive it around like...
To the club. They have a clubhouse where they have like a pool and like a lounge and all that. Like a retired clubhouse. And so you can take it back and forth to there. So that was hilarious. And then the thing that really topped it off to know that my parents are 100% retired is that they love birds. And just bird watching. And like they legit have an app where you open it up and it listens. And if a bird is chirping, it'll tell you what bird it is. So they'll just, we were going on hikes and everything. And my parents are just walking around with their phones like, oh, that's a cardinal. Oh, that's a robin. Oh, that's and I'm like, you guys are so retired. It hurts me right now.
Jeeper, Sean, I feel like we should get this app though, because then we would know if a raven was about to swoop us or if it was a magpie, you know?
That's very true. It could be like a pre-warning of what's around us here.
Jeepers. Also, it sounds very Truman Show. Sounds like they need to say, in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night. Yeah. Rented a car for all of last week. And, you know, new cars always have these bells and whistles where you're like, I didn't know this was possible. Or, well, this is interesting. And the one we rented was called a Hyundai Venue.
Oh, sure.
Yeah. And I kept, like, wanting to call it a Virtue or a Venture, but it's a Venue, which Venue. I don't really understand the name, but that's fine. It had a lot of beeping.
They're running out of car names, okay? Venue was the next one.
Okay. Well, it's not taking you to the Venue. It is the
you
Venue.
You are the Venue. Oh, because it has so many bells and whistles.
It did. It did. And it had, you know, the blind spot light on your mirror.
Very fun.
Not only that, it had a beep for the blind spot light that silenced your music. So,
oh, I would have turned that off.
I know. Kind of annoying. Also had like Apple CarPlay, which was really cool. So I could connect my phone and the GPS was right on the screen. Also, though, silenced your music when it was like, continue straight for 200 kilometers. It's like, I know I'm going straight. Why are you giving me this new instruction? You just cut out Hamilton the musical. It was a big darn, Sean. Alexander,
they were just getting
Hamilton.
To the good part.
They were. They always are. But then there was this other feature where it would go ding, 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 and a coffee cup would show up on the dash.
What does that mean?
Exactly. Had to look it up. It says, it seems like you are driving erratically and should take a break.
Oh, interesting. You like tired driving?
Yeah.
Wow.
But it was just, it was never that we were driving erratically. It's just that Ontario has those like bumpers on either side of you that's
sure.
like.
No, you're a bad driver. That's
Excuse
what it's saying.
Excuse me. I'm not
it's
a
like
bad driver.
Your driving is absolute. Terrible or you're really tired.
I was not either. I was just driving for the conditions and I needed to make sure I was in the middle lane, and if I ever ventured too close to the I didn't want to hear that, so I'd veer back over, Sean.
Driving to the conditions, it's summertime.
Excuse you, it's hard. Driving is difficult, and I can't tell you how many times I saw that coffee cup. It's a lot.
Jeez, never get in a car with you. I'm driving everywhere. I found out the hard way that I needed to renew my registration over the weekend, Steph.
Uh-oh, what is the hard way, Sean?
The hard way is getting pulled over by the police.
That's usually like a $400 ticket, too.
Is it?
Yes, it's happened to me before.
Oh, geez, well, I guess I don't know because I didn't get one.
Oh, aren't you blessed? Tell me what happened.
I'm a little cutie, a little sweet talker.
Oh, you must have. Did you cry as well?
No.
Oh, okay.
But no, I got pulled over. If anyone saw me, hello, how are you?
Everybody has a slow drive-by. Do I know that person that's pulled over and having a bad day?
Everyone does it, right? When you see someone pulled over, you're kind of like, do I know him? You take a peek, you look.
What'd you do wrong? Text you later, see what happens?
Yeah, I got pulled over on, it was like Saturday afternoon, evening. And it was just, I was like gutted. I was like, what did I do? I was just driving casually, like doing
casually,
nothing, like
minding my own business, not breaking any laws.
Yeah, and then he pulled me over, and he's like, "Yeah, I pulled you over because your license is or whatever, your car's not registered." And it's so different in Saskatchewan than it is here, and that's my excuse.
Okay, but you've lived in Alberta for 2 years and BC for a couple years before that, so you've been out of Saskatchewan for a while,
well,
Mr. Excuses.
But in Alberta, you can renew for 2 years, so I haven't had to touch my thing in 2 years. And so I know when my insurance is up, because that's the big one. right? And so that's up in September. So in Saskatchewan, it's all one. So I just thought, okay, so everything's, because I did it all at the same time.
Right.
So then I was like, why wouldn't everything just be in September? I didn't even know about like my car being registered. And so apparently it goes by last name or something.
Oh, yeah, yeah. For what time of the year that you have to... Yeah, yeah, because mine's in October, because mine starts with an S.
Oh, yeah, mine was just this past month. It was like a couple days ago, or whenever the start of the month is. That's when mine expired, so...
Wow, they were really on it. Like, I've been pulled over because I didn't register my car in October, and it was June, but... That's probably why they gave me that $400 ticket. But for you, if it just expired in May and they're like, June 16th is your day.
That's
You've
right.
got only 2 weeks to do it and now you're in trouble.
Yeah. I think I still had some of my pride makeup on though. So maybe that's what helped me. I was just batting my big eyelashes at the guy. I was like, please don't give me a ticket, officer. I can't afford it. I work in radio. While you were off last week, Steph, we had a lunch on Friday with the entire staff. We ordered in Mr. Mike's, and I want to say it was pretty tasty.
So you're trying to tell me that I super missed out?
You super missed out, and I'm going to rub it in a little bit because I'm going to tell you what we ate on Friday.
Oh, thank you so much, Shawn. All right, here
start
we
off,
go.
Yeah, start off big. There was amazing Korean barbecue ribs that we had. Mm. Those were fantastic. Tasty, tender, juicy, slopped on the sauce. Just a little messy, but that's what we want when we're having ribs.
Yeah, when you're having ribs, you need to have food on your face.
Absolutely. There was these like chicken bites, like kind of popcorn chicken, but bigger.
Oh, like chicken nuggets?
But like more textured.
Oh,
and
yeah.
And like more jagged.
Oh.
They weren't like a nugget. They were like kind of just like any different type of style and size.
I love that kind.
Yeah.
So much breading.
And then so much sauces too. So big shout out for all the sauce. I'm a big sauce guy. I like to kind of get a little curious and adventure with all the sauces.
And you're a double dipper too, but not in the sense that you like bite and then dip again. You're like, ooh, I'll try this sauce and this sauce on the same piece of chicken.
Oh, I'll still double dip. And then you claim dibs. And you're like, oops, that's my dip now. Oops, Shawn. Guys, I double dipped on this one.
Jeepers, I'm going to make sure I'm ahead of you in line every Friday now. If this is the way it's going to go, I was trying to make sure that you weren't a double dipper and you outed yourself.
I outed myself, yeah. And then there was like nachos that were just glazed with like this like cheesy nacho sauce. And then they just had a whole bunch of toppings and fixins on top of it all. There was these amazing fish tacos. Like the list goes. Anyways, I'm getting hungry now, but it was absolutely fantastic. So Mr. Mike's knocked it out of the park.
So what you're saying is, even though I missed Friday, I should probably make plans to go there for lunch today.
That's right. Or if someone else is like having a staff lunch or a staff meeting or something, just somehow try and get into their meeting for their Mr. Mike's catered lunch.
Perfect.
A big night coming up in Fort McMurray over in October. It's this Jillian Harris person that people apparently care about, Steph.
People do not just apparently care about her. Like, she is amazing, Shawn.
Yeah, I know her from The Bachelor. She was like one of the OG Canadians on The Bachelor.
Yes, and she was The Bachelorette.
Oh, and she was The Bachelorette.
Yes, yeah. And not only that, she was the designer on Love It or List It Vancouver.
That's where you lose me. I don't know about that. I know The Bachelor stuff.
Okay, well, HGTV loves her. She's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
But then not only that, she is like one of the OG influencers, I would say.
I would say so too. I vaguely remember her kind of kickstarting all of that.
Yeah, and like when she made it to 1 million followers, it was a really big deal.
Mm.
And she has the Jilly Box, which you can like kind of get a subscription to or buy a, you know, a box of all kind of like female owned, often Canadian businesses.
Yeah, those subscriber boxes. She started one of those as well.
Yeah, and then she also has the Jilly Academy. I could go on and on. She
fangirling over there.
She's amazing. I am totally getting tickets to this. But it's on October 20th. She is coming to town to do a talk.
Yeah, and I know a lot of people were trying to get tickets originally. And I don't know if they sold out or what, but anyways, we got free ones.
We got the hookups. If you want to win a pair of tickets to go see Jillian Harris and bring me as your plus one, you can head on over to our website, mix1037fm.com, and enter there.
Want more of today's show?
Download the Mixed Mornings and More podcast.
Now available every weekday.